Hey guys, welcome back to Skyrim. This ep, we are going to continue with the main questline. The task we have got is called Elder Knowledge. So we must try and find the location of an Elder Scroll so it can help us. I don't know, it's not going to help us learn the Dragon's Wrench shout, but it's going to help us somehow get rid of Alduin. Kill him, throw him ahead in time, I don't care what we do with him, I just want him gone. So, it is indicating that we need to go back to the College of Winterhold. So let's go back there. We've been there pretty... Oh, sorry, I'm indoors. Whoops. We were there pretty recently. What were we there for? Ah, the Stones of Baron Zaya. Yeah, there was a stone in the Archmage's quarters. Oh, wow, it's daylight. We can look at the courtyard. Hey, Esmond! Buddy! I tried to find you last step.
Ah, you're back. I hope you've made some progress on tracking down this shout.
Yes, I did. Except we need an Elder Scroll. Yeah.
Ah, indeed. There's a pretty puzzle.
You don't sound
not
very
the kind of thing
upset.
You'll find in your local bookshop.
Alas.
I'm sure you'll manage, though.
Do you have any idea where to find the scroll?
Do you know the College of Winterhold?
I'm actually the Archmage. I know you've been hiding in the Ratway for a while, so you've probably missed out on a lot, but that's happened. Any advice for fighting dragons? I don't. I'm okay. Cool. Well, let's just check out this courtyard while we're here. We've got some pretty dead-looking trees. That's a bit unfortunate. Maybe Espen will give them a good water, and they'll perk right up. Was that a blade? Oh, you're practicing your fighting! Okay, well, we'll have fun with that. There's my pretty temple. Ugh, stars in the night sky. This is a very beautiful location. But anyway, moving on to the college. Poor Yordas must be so cold. And now there's a dragon! What kind of dragon are you? Where are you going, buddy? What are you, and can I use ice against you? Oh, I think I hit Mjoll. I can't tell if that was you or Yordas, dragon. Guys, can we just, like, move into the college? Because then we're going to have some other mages helping us. And he's actually land. Nope, he is definitely an electric crystal dragon. Well, that's pretty. Guys, can we go in? Yeah, Yeldis has got the right idea. Let's head on in. Hopefully a follow. Oh dear. I'm terribly sorry. What have I done to take your clothes off you? Enthea. You're Enthea. I should probably heal. Sorry, I'm too busy looking at the people around me. Dragon. I'm trying to look at Enthea, because he doesn't even look like he's an elf anymore since they added a mod about appearances. Yay, I had the final shot with my magic. I'm just gonna take all that. Let's check you out. Oh, look at you, you've got the transparent bits. That's so cute. And oh, it's Onmund. Onmund, buddy. I mean, you look a little more appealing than before, but do you want to put some clothes on? Just saying. Wow, and Yordas's hilt has no fastening on her body, so it just floats by her side. Oh, that's what happens when you get mods. They're not exactly the most accurate. Hey guys, I'm back. I don't quite know who I'm here to see. I'm gonna assume it's Zerag. I'm not quite sure. Yeah, let's look at Zerag. Buddy, if you knew where an Elder Scroll was this entire time, why didn't you pipe up? We could have had that in our possession quite some time ago. Hi. It is Urag.
Why the audacity? How dare you imply such a thing?
Calm down. Why are you overreacting? I was going to ask if the two of you are collaborating on research.
Oh, well, I'm sorry, yes. We have been working on something together.
What's going on?
This is why I avoid being social.
Nah. I have no idea what you guys are talking about, but hey! Urag, I wish we probably come around the front of here. Hey, buddy!
May I help you, Archmage?
Absolutely. I'm looking for an Elder Scroll.
There are more books.
That is not what I clicked!
Here in the Arcanium.
I'm not interested.
Some other time, perhaps.
Can we please scroll down? I'm looking for an Elder Scroll. If you could please tell
me. And what do you plan to do?
Where I'm going.
Do you even know what you're asking about? Or are you just someone's errand girl?
Why is everybody so mean to me? Of course I do. Do you have
you
one here?
You think that even if I did have one here, I would let you see
why
it?
Why are you so
it
offensive?
It would be kept under the highest security. The greatest
thief
in the world
wouldn't be
able to lay a
finger on it.
Gosh,
how there's inconsistencies in this. That's the reply he would give to somebody he doesn't know. Okay, what about the Dragonborn?
What about? Wait, are you? Were you the one the Greybeards were calling? I'll bring everything we have on them. But it's
not. How did you not know the Archmage was a Dragonborn?
It's mostly lies, leavened with rumor and conjecture.
Okay. Well, great. Can you do that?
Until next time.
Am I supposed to, like, wait a day? Perhaps while you go fetch them? Or do I just patiently wait? Urag? Urag?
There we go. Try not to spill anything on them.
I'll do my best. Sorry, I was in your way. So, effects of the Elder Scrolls and ruminations on the Elder Scrolls. Okay, we'll start with this one. Started discerning the transmundane. Ruminations on the Elder Scrolls by Septimus Cygnus, College of Winterhold. Ask Urag about the insane book. Oh, this doesn't sound promising. Imagine living beneath the waves with the strong-sighted blessing of most excellent fabric. Holding the fabric over your gills, you would begin to breathe, drink its warp and weft. Though the plant matter fibers imbue your soul, the wretched plankton would pollute the cloth until it stank to heavens of prophecy. This is one manner in which the scrolls first came to pass. But are we the sea, or the breather, or the fabric? Or are we the breath itself? Can we flow through the scrolls as knowledge flows through, being the water? Or are we the stuck morass of sea filth that gathers on the edge? Imagine, again, this time but different. A bird cresting the wind is lifted by a gust and downed by a stone. But the stone can come from above, if the bird is upside down. Where, then, did the gust come from? And which direction? Did the gods send either, or has the bird decreed their presence by her own mind-making? The all-sight of the scrolls makes a turning of the mind such that relative positions are absolute in their primacy. I ask you again to imagine for me. This time, you are beneath the ground. A tiny acorn planted by some well-meaning elf maiden of the woodlands for her pleasure. You wish to grow, but fear what you may become, so you push off the water, the dirt, the sun, to stay in your hole. But it is in the very pushing that you become a tree, in spite of yourself. But how did that happen? The acorn is a kind of tree egg in this instance, and the knowledge is water and sun. We are the chicken inside the egg, but also the dirt. The knowledge from the scrolls is what we push against to become full-sighted ourselves. One final imagining before your mind closes from the shock of ever knowing. You are now a flame, burning bright blue within a vast emptiness. In time, you see your brothers and sisters, burnings of their own in the distance and along your side. A sea of pinpoints, a constellation of memories. Each burns bright, then flickers. Then two more take its place, but not forever lest the void fills with rancid light that sucks the thought. Each of our minds is actually the emptiness, and the learnings of the scrolls are the pinpoints. Without their stabbing light, my consciousness would be as a vast nothingness, unknowing its emptiness as a void is unknowing of itself. But the burnings are dangerous, and must be carefully tended and minded and brought to themselves and spread to their siblings. Wow. I'd like to know who wrote that. I mean, like, in real life. That's pretty interesting, actually. It's quite interesting. So we move on to the effects of the Elder Scrolls. It is widely known among scholars that the Elder Scrolls entail a certain hazard in their very reading. The mechanism of the effects has, at present, been largely unknown. Theories of hidden knowledge and divine retribution were the subject of idle speculation with this little investigation. I, Justinius... Is that a P or a D? I don't know. Delunius? Palania? Guys, I don't even care. Have undertaken to thoroughly document the elements afflicted by the Elder Scrolls on their readers, though a unified theory of how they manifest continues to elude me and remains a subject for future study. I have grouped the effects into four, finding that the avenue of experience depends largely upon the mind of the reader. If this is unclear, I hope that a proper dichotomy will lay it plain. Group the first. The what? Knaves? That does say knaves, right? The knaves. For one who has received no training in the history or nature of the Elder Scrolls, the scroll itself is, effectively, inert. No prophecy can be scryed, nor knowledge obtained. While the scroll will not impart learning to the uninformed, nor will it afflict them in any adverse fashion. Visually, the scroll will appear to be awash in odd lettering and symbols. Those who know their astronomy often claim to recognize constellations in the patterns and connections, but such conjecture is impossible to further investigate, since the very nature of this study necessitates unlearned subjects. Group the second, the unguarded intellects. It is the second group that realizes the greatest danger from attempting to read the scrolls. These are subjects who have an understanding of the nature of the Elder Scrolls and possess sufficient knowledge to actually read what is inscribed there. They have not, however, developed adequate discipline to stave off the mind-shattering effect of having a glimpse of the infinity. These unfortunate souls are struck immediately, irrevocably, and completely blind. Oh, Jesus, that sucks. Such is the price for overreaching one's faculties. It bears mentioning, though, that with the blindness also comes a fragment of that hidden knowledge, whether the future, the past, or the deep natures of being is independent and on the individual and their place in the greater spheres. But the knowledge does come, so you would willingly sacrifice your sight to have some sort of greater knowledge, even if it's of the past? I mean, that'd be so useless. Group the third, mediated understanding. Alone in Tamriel, it would appear that only the cult of the ancestor Moth has discovered the discipline to properly guard one's mind when reading the scrolls. Their novitiates must undergo the most rigorous mental cultivation, and they often spend a decade or more at the monastery before being allowed to read their first Elder Scroll. The monks say this is for the initiate's own protection, as they must have witnessed many unguarded intellects among their more eager ranks. That's a very good point. With appropriate fortitude, these readers also receive blindness, though at a far lesser magnitude than the unguarded. Their vision fogs slightly, but they retain shape, colour, and enough acuity to continue to read mundane texts. The knowledge they gain from the scrolls is also tempered somewhat. It requires stages of meditation and reflection to fully appreciate and express what one saw. Group the fourth, illuminated understanding. Between the previous group and this one exists a continuum that has, at present, only been traversed by the monks of the Ancestor Moth. With continued readings, the monks become gradually more and more blind, but receive greater and more detailed knowledge. As they spend their waking hours pondering their revelations, they also receive a further degree of mental fortitude. There is, for every monk, a day of penultimate reading, when the only knowledge the Elder Scroll imparts is that the monk's next reading shall be his last. That's depressing, but nice that you've got the forewarning that it would be your last vision. That's pretty cool. For each monk, the penultimate reading comes at a different and unknowable time. Preliminary work has been done to predict the occurrence by charting the severity of an individual monk's blindness, but all who reach these later stages report that the increasing blindness seems to taper with increased readings. Some pose the notion that some other, unseen senses, in fact, continuing to diminish at this upper range, but I shall leave such postulations to philosophers. Wise idea. To prepare for his ultimate reading, a monk typically withdraws to seclusion in order to reflect upon a lifetime of revelations and appoint his mind for reception of his last. Upon this final reading, he is forever blinded, as sure as those unguarded ones who raced to knowledge. The illuminated one, though, has retained his understanding over a lifetime and typically possesses a more integral notion of what has been revealed to him. It is hoped that this catalogue will prove useful to those who wish to further our mortal understanding of the Elder Scrolls. The Moth Priests remain aloof about these matters, taking the gradual debilitation that comes with the reading as a point of pride. May this serve as a useful starting point for those hoping to take up such study. Dictated to Anstius Mechim. Mechim? I don't know. Fourth of Last Seed in the 126th year of the Second Era. This person is a bit of a problem. If I cannot read the Elder Scrolls, how can I use it to destroy Alduin in some fashion? I'm not quite sure how to go about that. Do I need a Moth Priest? Do they still exist?
Greetings, Archmage.
Can you tell me? This ruminations book is incomprehensible. Actually, I found it quite entertaining, but okay.
There are more books to be recovered and secured here in the Arcadium.
That's not what I clicked, goddammit.
Some other time, perhaps.
Scroll, bruh, scroll. This one.
I That's the work of Septimus Cygnus.
Tis.
He's the world's master of the nature of Elder Scrolls. But, well, he's been gone for a long while. Too long.
Is he dead? He's dead, or did he just go somewhere?
Oh, no. I hope not.
No.
But even I haven't seen him in years.
So this book was recently written.
I became obsessed with the Dwemer. Took off North Sangiet bound some old artifact.
No,
not
the Dwemer.
Somewhere in the ice fields, if you want to try to find him.
Must I? I really don't want to. Okay. Hey, The Rise and Fall of the Blades. Have I read that one before? Have I read this one before? I don't know. Let's give it a go. There are many that still remember the Blades. There are fewer that can pass down the stories, their origins, and their downfall. My father could. In his proudest moments, he said to me, "You keep secrets like the Blades." The Blades were good at keeping secrets. They didn't write down much. They passed information carefully between their spies in every province, to their elite members that protected the emperors. Even amongst their members, they kept much secret. That could be said of every single organization, to be honest. Even businesses. Most associate the Blades with their ceremonial Akaviri armor and curved longswords. One can trace the Blades back to the fiercest warriors of Akavir, the Dragon Guard. Dragon Guard? Oh, that sounds so much better than the Dawn Guard. It was there, just as they would do in Tamriel, that they protected rulers and their kingdom. But recent discoveries show it to be much more than that. Many classic texts tell us of adventures to Akavir, known as the Dragonlands of the East. Can I go to Akavir? Many from Tamriel have attempted to conquer it, most famously Emperor Uriel V and his 10th Legion and 3rd Era 288, as documents in the Imperial Dispatch Disaster at Ironeth. Dragons have long been legend in Akavir, and many believe that their brief appearance in Tamriel's history are those that escaped Akavir, for it was there that they were hunted and killed off by the Dragon Guard. The Dragon Guard would follow those that fled to Tamriel in the late First Era. Invading from the north, the Dragon Guard met not only dragons, but the men of Skyrim, who don't meet invasions with pitchers of mead. Ha! Ha! The Dragon Guard cut a path through Skyrim, and it was not until they were stopped by Roman Cyrodiil during the Battle of at Pale Pass that the invasion came to an end. It was Roman who united the human lands of Cyrodiil and defeated the Akaviri invaders. Well, what about the dragons? And people of Skyrim got rid of the Dragon Guard, but what do they do with the dragons that invaded? Roman is one of the first documented and widely accepted of the mythic dragonborn. Really? Those anointed by Akatosh and Alessia themselves, born with the soul of a dragon, is what his followers would say. Reports differ widely on the nature of the battle at Pale Pass, but the end result is the same. That the remaining Dragon Guard, upon bearing the voice here, I hate this writing, it's hard to read. Upon hearing the voice of Roman Cyrodiil, knelt and swore their lives to him, their conqueror and savior. Fragments from late First Era texts refer to the first warriors dropping to their knees, saying, "We were not hunting," or "did not intend." Author, rough translation, continuing, "We have been searching for you." They protected Roman with their lives, as well as his descendants. As the Roman dynasty ushered in Tamriel's Second Era, it was through these years that their reach extended, and their order grew to become the Blades. Their conquest of the dragons complete, they only sought to protect the Dragonborn, and through him, the Empire. They reached their height late during the Third Era, under the rule of the Septim Emperors. Despite their numbers, they kept their secrecy. The most visible and well-documented were the members who personally guarded the Emperor, still wearing the original Akaviri armor. But that was just the tip of the spear. For the Blades were a large organization stretching to every corner of Tamriel. These agents were of every race. They were merchants, thieves, craftsmen, mages, and warriors, all acting as spies, protecting the Empire as needed, and operating in secret. They often acted alone, but some fragments speak of them meeting in secret fortresses across the continent. So the Blades were kind of like a spy network. That is pretty cool. The most famous being Cyrodiil's Cloud Ruler Temple, where they hung the swords of those slain protecting the Dragonborn. Other maps speak of Wind Scout Temple under the great expanse of Hammerfell's Alakir Desert, Skyhaven Temple and the mountains of Skyrim, and Stormtalon Temple east of Wayrest. Oh, I so wish we could go to all of these different places and all the different different Elder Scroll games. That'd be so cool. Oh my god, how long is this book? They were known to have a grandmaster who often lived amongst the people, unknown to others. The nature of their communications, meeting places, and missions were known to only a few elite members. The only two to know all were the grandmaster himself and the chronicler, whose only job was to make sure the group's mission was never known, but never lost. The death of Uriel Septim VII and his son, Martin, that's a great name for Uriel. The third era came to a close, with the Blades fortifying themselves deep within Cyrodiil's Cloud Ruler Temple, as they waited for a Dragonborn to return when they would be called upon again. Does that mean that there's some Blades still hiding in the Cloud Ruler Temple waiting for me? I don't know. The Empire of the Fourth Era no longer saw the Blades openly protecting it, or the Emperors. That role is now filled by the Penitus Oculatus, a purely Imperial organization. But the Blades continued their secret work to watch for the Dragonborn and guard against future enemies. The Blades were among the first to see the signs that the Thalmor of the Almeri Dominion would not remain isolated within their borders forever. They would do what the Penitus Oculatus, servant to the Imperial policy, could not, and thus earned the lasting hatred of the Thalmor. That's not such a bad thing. The warnings of the Blades were proved right, as is well known to all. The great war between the Empire and the Thalmor consumed the Empire and nearly destroyed it. Empress Titus Mead II eventually brokered peace with the Thalmor, but at a price many of us still bear. The reach and destructive nature of the Thalmor is known to many, author's note, in my family firsthand. They are not fools. They knew early on that the Blades were an enemy, so they hunted them throughout the Great War. Some were killed defending the temples, others as they slept in their hideaways, alone. Some fought, some ran, some hid, but the Thalmor found them all. There are those that say the Blades still exist around us, in hiding from the Thalmor, waiting, as they have done time and time again, for a Dragonborn to return, for one to protect, for one to guide them. I would still like to know whether there are other Blades aside from Esbern and Delphine. It insinuates that there are quite a few of them just chilling and hiding out in society. So that'd be pretty cool if I could just stumble across them one day. Where are we going now? Oh my. Oh my. That's a long way up. I can't actually get there from Winterhold College of. I might have to go to the actual city itself. And I can't get down from there either. I would have to go down around. Although, I could probably go that way. My god, it might just be quicker. We gotta go to Iskrimor's tomb. Except I can't do that from where I am. Okay, we're gonna go to Iskrimor's tomb, guys. Ladies, roll out. And once again, we are confronted with the sight of Eurus's perky butt. Is there anything you can help me with? Well, I would love it if you could just put some sort of cloth over your backside. You know, like a loincloth, but in the back as well as the front. That'd be delightful. But since you were unable to oblige, never mind. Do you think I could go overland there? That is certainly worth an attempt. So, we'll go around Iskrimor's tomb. See if I can get across. That would be delightful if I could. Oh, it's a lot further away than I anticipated. Can I swim that far? Is that even possible? Is it something I should be doing? Can you keep your head above water, Winter? I don't want you to drown. Oh, that just looks so freaking cold. I'm sort of reluctant to go straight in case I can't get out or I drown or something. Let's just go to this land and reassess. Ah, it's a hawker. Ah, there's lots of hawkers. No hawker, no. It's not acceptable to attack me. Okay, this looks like it. Okay. Septimus Cygnus's outpost discovered. Oh, this is where the writer was. Okay, yep. Oh, that's right. The writer's missing. That's what we're supposed to be looking for. Duh. Sorry, brain fade. Happens frequently. Should probably get some magic out. Although, he seems to be moving just fine down there. Yo, Septimus. What's up, bruh? What have you been doing? Bodrag is missing you. Hey, buddy. That's a pretty cool door you got there.
Dig. Dwemer in the beyond, I'll know your lost unknown and rise to your depths.
Yep, you clearly wrote that book. I heard you know about Elder Scrolls. good sir.
Elder Scrolls, indeed. The Empire, they absconded with them. Or so they think. The ones they saw. The ones they thought they saw.
So they weren't real.
I know of one. Forgotten.
And it's gonna be in the Gemarons, isn't it?
But I cannot go to it. Not poor Septimus. For I have arisen beyond its grasp.
Huh? So where is the scroll?
Here.
I knew
well,
it.
Well, here as in this plane. Mundus.
Oh, well, that's useful.
Nearby.
Thanks for that, Septimus.
Relatively speaking, on the cosmological scale, well, it's all
you're
nearby.
As mad as Cicero. Can you help me or not?
One block lifts the other. Septimus will give what you want, but you must bring him
naturally
something in return.
It's the way of the world. What do you want?
You see this masterwork of the Dwemer, deep inside their greatest knowings.
Is that Mule Shadow?
Septimus
that's
is
monstrous.
Clever among men, but he is but an idiot child compared to the dullest of the Dwemer. Lucky then they left behind their own way of reading the Elder Scrolls. In the depths of Black Reach, one yet lies. Have you heard of Black Reach?
No.
Cast upon where Drimmer City slept, the yearning spire hidden learnings kept.
So where's Black Reach?
Under deep, below the dark, the hidden keep. Tower Mzark.
Tower Mzark.
The point of puncture, of first entry, of the
so we need to find Aftand.
Delve to its limits, and Black Reach lies just beyond.
Sounds like a time-consuming journey.
But not all can enter there. Only Septimus knows the hidden key to loose the lock, to jump beneath the deathly rock.
Are you going to share this with me?
Two things I have for you. Two shapes. One edged, one round.
Sword and shield?
The round one for tuning. Dwemer music is soft and subtle, and needed to open their cleverest gates.
Uh-huh.
The edged lexicon for inscribing.
Not a lexicon.
To us, a hunk of metal. To the Dwemer.
I don't want another lexicon. I had to put one back.
Knowings, but empty. Find Mzark and its sky dome. The machinations there will read the scroll and lay the lore upon the cube. Trust Septimus.
That doesn't tell me what you want out of this.
My first creature in a cave, just like this.
Okay. What do I do with the sphere?
The deepest doors of Dwemer listen for singing. It plays the attitude of notes proper for opening. Can you not hear it? Too low for hearings?
What do you want with
Ooh.
The Elder Scroll?
An observant one.
Well, you never told me what you wanted.
Never to ask of Septimus.
What do you want?
This Dwemer lockbox. Look upon it and wonder. Inside is the heart. The heart of a god.
Oh, dear.
The heart of you.
That's not going to end well, I think.
But it was hidden away. Not by the dwarves, you see. They were already gone. Someone else. Unseen.
A Daedra?
Unknown. Found the heart, and with a flair for the ironical, used dwarven
I'm gonna say it was a Daedra. It must
the
be a Daedra heart then.
Will give the deep vision needed to open.
I don't know that I
for
want to give
even
that
the strongest imaginations of the Dwemer can hold off the all sight given by an Elder Scroll.
Okay, well, thanks, buddy. Oh, wait, what? I'm leaving? Where am I going? Here. Ah, so Aftend is there. Okay. Oh, how the hell do I get up there? Will I have to go, like, from Sarthal? Or is it not on this side of the mountain, it's on the other side of the mountain? How do I... There we go, that's what I wanted. There we go. That's a much better view. It tells me that, no, it is clearly not on a mountain. I will still go from Sarthal. But it's just going to be a straight journey from there. Okay. Excellent. That just saved me a lot of time putting around. Treasure down here. There's no treasure here, Mjoll. Not unless you can get through that big Dwemer door. Never thought I'd be back here. I thought I was done with Sarthel. So this does seem a pretty straightforward path up the mountain, I believe. Or across the mountains. This looks like it might be a pass. Try this way. And yet again, a road trip conducted at night time. It does seem to be the go-to. I can't get through here. Well, this was a short-lived trip. Oh no, I can go this way. Never mind. I know what I'm doing. I never know what I'm doing, but that's no surprise to anybody. Here we go. Are these sort of up or down? Now that's the question. Around, I think. Around. Oh, around up or around down? Let's try around up. Come on, Winter. Use that jumping skill I know you possess. Oh, dear God. Well. Maybe we'll be going down and saving. Worry about than you. It's all the same to you. Ooh, is this a light I see? No. Just buildings. I hope as though was it a frost troll here? I really don't like them. A damn thing. It's too freaking dark. Oops. Here. Can I get in through here? Aftan's Road Tower. I don't know if this really gets me anywhere though. Holy shit.
You're mine.
And I need to put flames on as four because as we know, I see nothing. Oh, it's another one you're battling. Well, that's unfortunate. Pan. Activate button. Well, I'm sorry about that. I might have to deactivate that one for you. Oh, so we have to go through the flames to get through. Well, that's unfortunate. Ouch. Oh, wait, yep, I saw that. Can you watch out for the marks? The trap floor button things? Holy shit, it's one of you! Ah! I'm trying not to hit you, Yordas. I'm trying very hard not to hit you. You make it very difficult when you walk in front of me. I don't even know that I'm in the right place, to be honest. I mean, I'm in some sort of tower. I wasn't meant to be in a tower. Fine, why would you want to even... Oh, I suppose the Dwemer want to attack the intrusion. Intruding people? Nope. I don't do expert. Ah! Wow. Please don't jump scare me next time.
There you are.
Oh god, there's a door. They always seem to travel on packs. Okay. Getting us somewhere. I don't really know where, but we'll take it. Open to Skyrim. But my marker said it was inside. Did I go the wrong way? No? Yes? No? Huh? How does one? This way. Put that away.
I love the cold there.
And try and get up?
Perhaps it's because of my north.
Here we go. I've done discovered. Oh wow, what's happened to this place? It's a bit run down. Anything useful? Anything in this chest? It's no. How about we don't unlock that? Is this where I'm supposed to be going? I don't know. I can't even get in the building. So I'm gonna say it's not. In that case then, where the heck am I going? That's it. Daytime, I can't see a thing. It's probably not long enough. Okay, is the entrance here somewhere? Like there. Here we go. See, I knew I needed daytime for something. This is much better. And down. I'm looking for an entrance here to the glacial ruins. Please, let us go that way. I'm sorry, Yordis, you must be freezing your tits off. Beauty is pain. That's what they say.
Watch the walls for the sphere constructs. They can appear in the
I don't know what's gonna happen here, to be honest, Mjoll, but thank you for your concern. I think I'm more likely to be attacked by Draugr, to be honest. That's the kind of place they live.
Where is it? I know you were trying to keep it for yourself, Chisar. You always try to keep it.
The Khajiit here.
No.
Oh my god, where are you, crazy Khajiit? Can I go this way? No, sorry, it's a wall. It's really hard to tell. Maybe not for you, but on my screen it is. I think I'm in the opposite direction to the voices, because they've disappeared. Oh well. This place is very strange. Just the way it's constructed, it's very odd. Research notes, yes, please. Whose research notes are these? Does it tell me? Nope. Oh my god, how tiny is this text? If only Umana would have left one of those dwarven machine creatures intact for me to study. The fact that they almost killed those Khajiit brothers in the middle of the night doesn't mean we couldn't have found a way to disable one. Are those the Khajiit brothers that I just heard before? We dragged some stuff in front of the pipes. They came out. We dragged some of the stuff in front of the pipes they came out of to stop them from coming back. They are simply fascinating. It is just as Kelsimo described in Dwarves version 2. Their appearance does, in fact, resemble that of an arachnid. Well, I had thought that to be an embellishment given by his source. The inclusion of the soul gem into the design of the apparatus is quite remarkable. Bloody soul gems. Huh? That was strange. I thought I just saw something moving beyond the barred door. It looked vaguely humanoid. I wonder if it could be an undiscovered automaton. I'm going to move my bedroll down here to see if I can catch another glimpse of it. This is all so exciting! Yeah, I wouldn't go that far. So you saw something moving from behind here. That's lovely, but I cannot get past there. And there does not appear to be anything to activate said door, so... I'm not quite sure what happened to you. I don't see a bedroll either. Well, we will press forward this way and see if it... I can hear something. Oh, there you are!
That's how a true Nord fights.
True Nord. Oh, I should really get my sword out. That way I can flame and strike. Much better.
Done that without you.
Are we getting closer to the Khajiit? Perhaps.
What was that?
Much quicker if I have my sword out. Why is that torch lying conspicuously on the ground?
Another of the smooth skins looking for food?
Hi! I'm not going to attack me. Sorry, I was putting my stuff away so that I didn't attack you, but you seem quite eager. You should be brutalized. Thus. Where's your brother, Khajiit? Can I find him? Hey, buddy! A wolf mask. That's terrifying. Let's take it. Nope. I don't want any of that. An axe isn't going to get you very far. FYI. Where's your brother? How have I lost your brother? Is there anything else here? This is a journal here. Here we go. Journal. Lumana's journal. That's great. Let's just skip through. I've heard in my sleep. Oh. I don't know if the echoes of screams I have heard in my sleep are those of our missing comrades or of my own nightmares. Well, good luck with those nightmares. I hope for your sake you don't die. Oh dear. This doesn't look promising. See? Ah, shit. Why did I use fire? God freaking damn it. I was just asking to kill one of my comrades. Sorry, ladies. That was very uncoordinated of me. I apologize profusely. A great assault gem. Again, I don't really use those, but I will take it. I'm still short of Khajiit. Ah, shit. Why does my left hand not have anything in it? Oh, whatever. Doesn't even matter. I healed. Well, that doesn't look good. Hey, buddy. Oh shit. More of that. I keep forgetting. You're as good as dead. No, he is dead.
Couldn't have done that without you.
Any more going to appear? That's just to unlock to get to the chest, which I don't need, so let's head through this ominous door. And safe before we continue on.
I almost died in a ruin just like this.
I know. And I had to go fetch Grim's ever for you. What are you doing?
Come on.
A dwarven spider worker. That's the last of them. Well, there was only one. Okay, it sounds like bad things are gonna happen. Oh my god, check out all this awesome stuff. That's what I heard. Which. Let's go this way.
What was that?
Oh, dear god. What the hell was that? Okay, I do think that's a dead end. Ladies, let's go the other way. And this way. I hate it when they give me options. I like linear paths. Nothing here.
Huh?
Huh? Same as that. Let's just continue on. Ooh. Oh, now we've got options. We've got a door. Oh, we have to unlock that. So no, this is not the one I want. Never mind. Just glitched there. Hi, buddy. What's up? You're just chilling in the corner? I'm not too prerogative, really, at the end of the day. But it's not really how I'd play out life. Excuse me, Mol. I'd like to get out. Thank you very much. Oh, it's one of those stupid things. Can you go in? I'm gonna describe you. Because I can do that. Oh god, I just hit myself. Uh-huh. It's nice. Hey, whoops, someone's here. Ah-ha! Oh, you just knocked your spider down! Oh, that's hilarious. Okay, ladies, try not to fall. I don't know what's down there. I don't quite know how to get back up if you've fallen down. So good luck with that! Did you both fall? You both fell. Oh no, there's Mule. Lotus must have fallen. Poor dear. Well, I hope you can join us once we go through this door. I'm sure you can, because it looks like it's a door that reloads. Yeah, see? The animunculary. We went to one of these at the last Dwemer joint you went to. Why did we go to another Dwemer place? Must have been for the Stones of Baron Zahar, I think. I don't like options. That's good, that's not an option. Perfect. We're still short of Khajiit. Has he come this way? Have you seen him, Mr. Spider?
Oh no, you don't. I'm sorry, but you left me with no choice. What was that?
I can just flame that. Set it all alight. Where I can't accidentally do it when I stand on it. Oh wow, we should really heal. Probably the best idea I could do. There we go. Now what are we doing? What are you? Oh, you're a chair. It's a very strange chair. No judgment, of course. Yeah, I saw that coming actually. It's why I kept to the side. Careful, ladies! It's always Miola gets caught in those things. Hi! I can't really afford to die, so if you could just not attack me. That'd be awesome. I never get healing on my other hand, or do I do it and it just is invisible? I'm really not sure. Ah, shit. How? Oh, I can activate the lever from here? That's glitchy. That is immensely glitchy. How is that even physically possible? It's not physically possible. I think I'm going down. Just this guy here. Oh, I would actually be asking, is there something there? Because it's a thing, not a one, not a person. Anybody else? Oh dear, that looks like thermal stuff. Who are you attacking, guys? Oh, none of them. Oh, no. Do I have to unlock that thing? Like, seriously, do I have to? Is it necessary? Can I just jump down? I don't know. I think I might have to unlock it. I don't wanna! Oh, well, there you go. First time lucky. Are you digging or something? Because you're a worker spider. Sorry, Yordas. No, definitely not expert. Expert, we are not. Cool, we'll take the lot. That is not the path forward. Which means you must be the... Are you the path forward? You don't look like you are, to be honest. And that begs the question, where the hell do we go from here? I don't get it. Is there a path we missed? There's no path downwards unless we jump. And I don't really know that that's the best option available to us. Because there's no way down through there. Okay, well, I'm just going to jump down and see if that is of any benefit. I don't know that it will be, but... See you later, guys! Yeah. Well, you would have followed. Mule isn't, though. Nope, Mule does not want to follow. Oh, there she goes. Oh, holy cow. Hi, sorry, I was just looking at my follower trying to kill herself. Where is my sword? Why am I so fighting with my bare hands? Bare knuckles. Oh my god, I am so unbelievably lost. Where the hell am I? And where the hell am I supposed to be going? Am I supposed to be going up or down? I don't even know. The heck? Okay, well this was not the right place. Apparently. You really shouldn't stand on that. What is it's gonna do that?
These are the most dangerous, but the most profitable types of ruins.
That's nice, but am I going down again? Oh, I can go down. Awesome. Okay, well, let's head down. Let's see if that's where I'm supposed to be going. Oh, God. I didn't even know they were here. Careful, ladies. Do not plummet to your deaths because I can't do anything about it. Oh, I told you it was Thalma. Oh, my God. Why am I not striking this guy? Should have been doing that all along. Sorry, my sword disappeared because I changed to magic. So my sword was not there for that animation. Oops. Although, are there going to be any other spiders? Because I can change to... Hi, what happened to you? I can change back to my ice if it's just going to be the Thalma. That sucks. Ladies, watch out for the fire. Anytime now. I mean, I can just go around. I'll just go around. Watch it, meow. This is definitely Thalma territory. So, I have no defense when I'm wearing robes. Sucks. These are big ruins. It's taking us all kinds of places. Ladies, feel free to join me at any point in time.
You won't get away.
Oh, hi, you have a friend. I didn't know you had a friend. I'm just gonna wait for that to... Yeah? Great. That health just regenerates so slowly. I do not have the patience for that. Plus, if I do kill myself, it does increase my magic skills. Although I'm a bit too high for that to have an impact. But it all adds up, it all accumulates, and holy shit, get out of there. That's back, ladies. Is this button necessary? Oh, it's a floor! It's a travelling floor! It's a lift! Ah, oh, it doesn't even matter. You guys gotta follow me, whether you're on the lift or not. Well, the place looks a little bloody. That's my first impression. What do you ladies think of it? Oh, leave up, leave up, leave up.
I'm right.
No, I'm sorry, honey. I just want the bat. Wonderful. More books? No, I don't really want that. Research notes. Did I just go full circle? Oh my god. I just went full circle. And I did not find anything. Okay. Back it up. Let's take the lift back up. And see what the map says. God, I can't believe we've just completely and utterly missed it. Where's the lift, guys? How did I miss it? Is it because I got stuck and I jumped down because I couldn't see a way forward? Where are you? I don't really get it, but we're going up, I believe, which is where we just came from. Oh, there are two stairs here. Oh, it doesn't really get you anywhere though. So much for that excitement. Okay, let's continue up this way. And we'll always just assess to make sure we're going the right way. Yeah, okay, something to the right. How do I... There's nothing here. I mean, you can't go into those huts. It doesn't get you anywhere. At least you never used to be able to do anything, no, because it's just a hut. Ah, oh, shoot, I knew that would happen.
Is there something I can help you with?
You can, Yordas, if you could just step a little bit out of the way. Okay, we'll go back around. There's nothing through there. Does that ever stop? Well, we'll just go through it. Not going to kill. We'll go this way. It should be, like, here somewhere. Apparently. And I've overshot the mark. Where? How do I get to the cathedral? How does one get to the cathedral? I'm practically on top of it. What am I missing? Is it above me? Is it below me? Is it like the next level back up? I don't understand. Let's get back down to the beginning. Oh, is there more this way that I happen to miss? Should I go this way before? God, I'm getting lost. Is this the right way? We've not opened this door before. Here we go. Is this the way we're supposed to be going? Oh, it just takes us back to here. Which isn't ideal. Maybe it's beneath us. Maybe that's it. Here we go. Great. New enemies means we haven't been here before. Oh my god, look at them all. Why are there so many?
Oops.
Decomposing body I've ever seen. I think I saved it, but I'm gonna save it again anyway. Here we go. This is where we want to be, guys. What a twit. I completely missed the exit because I saw the lift and just went where the lift went. Watch out for that, guys. I'm gonna do that. The cathedral! Finally! Excellent. We're on the trail, ladies. Watch out for those pressure plates. Like that. I give them the warning and then, like, instigate it myself. Shut it off.
That's what I thought.
Wow. Flames do nothing to you. Pretty much. I'm not. You can also make a follower get behind you by drawing your weapon when you are colliding with them. That is very odd, but good for the orders! I'm going to put my ice back on since we don't seem to be encountering any other. Oh, what's it called? The dwarven spider thingies. Yeah, well, which way am I going? Holy, hi! I didn't see you, I'm terribly sorry. I just need to overlook you.
I'm disappointed.
Oh, is this gonna be another puzzle about how to unlock the doors? Damn it. Okay, well, let's try. Or maybe not a puzzle after all. That's actually pretty straightforward. See, remember last time we had to do one on the left and one on the right? And that caused me no end of confusion. When was that? That was when we were trying to hunt down Mercer Frey. With Carla. Oh, frig.
There you are.
Treat me kindly. Oh, you don't do ice storm. Okay, back to flames. I spoke way too soon, apparently. And heal before we engage in more combat. Although they are wailing on him really easily. Thanks, ladies. If only you killing something got my skills up. That would be awesome. Unfortunately, it doesn't quite work that way. Hey, I've got a key. I've got a key. Does it lead to beyond here? Me think so. And yet again, swatted by a door. Hi.
Why does she want me to leave? Just waiting for me to turn my back. So you can have all the glory for yourself. What was that?
How did you miss us? I was right here. I see you in Imperial. Oh, I'm so sorry, Mel. magic. Gosh. Oh, and through the armor, because that is really realistic.
Thanks.
Love it.
Couldn't have done that without you.
Okay, well, I'm really sorry about that, guys. Well, the heck, we'll sell the lot. Taj of the Blood. Oh, it's just a... Okay. Let's use this dwarven mechanism, whatever it may... Oh, dear God. Is that a stair case? Huh, it is too. This is cool. I like this. Let's proceed, ladies, with caution. Is it still a Dwemer woman? Ah, Blackreach. Sweet.